family and friends. I dedicate every fight to all my family and friends. So,
Shakur, you've had a lot of big moments in your career. I'm just getting kind of curious, like, if you feel pressure coming in this fight, comparing it to your gold medal match years ago.
Nah, it's a whole different story. With the gold medal match, I'm probably a lot more calmer, right, for this fight than I was for my gold medal fight. I was younger at that time. Now I'm 24 years old. I done been in these arenas so many times. It's natural. It's normal to me now.
So you don't feel like any nerves or anxiousness or even like pressure that you're putting on yourself?
Nah, not at all. You can't put no pressure on yourself. At the end of the day, my grandfather told me as a kid that you only could worry about the things that you got control over. So I only got control over me going to training camp, giving 100% of my all, coming in shape, sharp. And that's what I got control over. After I go in the ring, I got control over that too. And I got to go in there and do what I got to do. I'm not worried about what's going on outside the ring. Not worried about how many people there is. Only me and Oscar in there.
What is it, man? You believe in the sweet science of hit and not get hit, just like Tyson Fury and Loma Chico. So why do you think some reporters imply that you are boring, but they don't say that about Tyson Fury and Loma Chico?
I don't know, man. I think certain people got biased opinions, I guess, but it is what it is. I ain't going to trip on it no more. People want to say what they want to say regardless. Like, if you really think about it, I could go beat Valdez. The next excuse might be, oh, he's too little. Or when I beat Heron, they going to say, oh, he's too old. And like, you're going to get critics regardless at the end of the day. So I can't take anything that they saying to heart no more because you know, there's a lot of people behind keyboards and all that stuff. They got to, feel me, you never know who behind the keyboard. It might be a little three-year-old playing around. Like, you never know, so I ain't tripping.
Shakur, what did you say to him in the face-off? You started laughing. You were smiling as well. What did you guys say to each other?
I said, you got to break the code. You got to crack the code. And I had to let him know that this is not a difficult task. And I wanted him to know, come fight day, this is a difficult task, basically. Like, it's real difficult.
What does it mean to you?
You're the bigger fighter, you're the longer fighter. How do you think how do you think that's going to play itself out in this fight on Saturday because of those two big advantages you hold?
I feel like I'm the more skillful fighter. I'm faster. I never know who really the bigger fighter until fight day because a lot of people say
with him, you look bigger than him.
Yeah, but when I stood with Jamel was big than a motherfucker, and then no homo. He was big as hell, and then when I got in the ring, he felt little. Like I touched gloves, and I'm like, yo, this dude little. Like I kind of seen that, so you never know who is big until like actual fight day.
How much
you said nobody beat.